It is time now to get a bit of entertainment news. Angela Bishop is back on the panel this morning. Let's welcome her.
Oh, I love that lady. How are you going?
Ange.
What?
I have serious leopard print envy.
Okay. And you have been trotting around the globe.
Trotting?
Been,
it was more of a canter.
It was a canter. Strutting. You know, rubbing shoulders with people in LA. How was it all?
Absolutely fantastic. One of the best trips I've had in years. I love it when a plan comes together, when Kate Blanchett wins every award known to man.
What was
every
she doing single ceremony. To her SAG award, by the way?
Oh, she was showing it a lot of love.
Wasn't she?
A lot of love.
Many
indeed.
A gif, many a meme has been generated from that.
Bless
very
her.
Funny.
See, not only does she win awards elegantly, she generates social media material. That's the kind of caring, sharing woman she is. So
yes.
It's good.
Yes. All right, lots to talk about this morning. Yes. What's going on in Radioland?
Well, huge changes, thanks to people like your good self, Kate, in both Sydney and Melbourne, with new FM radio teams taking the helm around the country. And yesterday in Sydney, it was the return of Kyle and Jackie O to the airwaves in Sydney, but on a brand new station. It used to be Mix. They're coming off a 3.3% rating, so they've got a long way to go. But their own ratings at Today FM, their previous station, were 52 straight wins in the surveys and number one FM.
They're amazing.
They're hoping they can bring that audience across quickly.
That'll never happen.
Now, you don't think so? Now, of course, that's Joe Hildebrand speaking as a new employee of On Stereo, one of the rivals of ARN. So he can be heard Triple M afternoons,
that's
I
right.
believe.
Boy, that's a show to watch.
And you had your first show yesterday.
Yeah.
I didn't see the coverage of that.
That's going very well.
Yeah, no
just
coverage of that.
The same media frenzy was there, I think.
That's right, so I'll shut up now.
But one of the key things you would have learned starting in radio yesterday was to get the call sign right. So if, like Kyle and Jackie O, you're on a brand new station called KIIS 106.5, probably don't say Today FM in your call sign, which is what Kyle did yesterday. Here's what Jackie had to say about that.
And you didn't even notice.
He
said put his headphones off and he just carried on. I said, Dale, you said Today FM. What are you doing? What are we going to do? Do we beep it? No, just acknowledge it. I mean, it is what it is, I think
it's like, I think there's anyone out there that's ever, you know, called someone the wrong name in a moment of passion.
It's a bit like that.
It's exactly the same. It's bad. There's no getting around it. It's not to be done.
12 years they were with Today FM, so I guess old habits die hard.
What a trooper. I can't believe other people think they've got problems. And then you look what Kyle has to deal with every day.
Now, there's been big news in television. Right, Helen Kapalos, the host of Today Tonight, has quit.
She has quit to go to another program within the network. It's a primetime current affairs program on Sunday nights called Sunday Night. She will go from being a presenter to a reporter. She says that's long been her aim, to do long-form storytelling. And it is leading to a huge amount of speculation about the future of Today Tonight and as to whether this will be Channel 7's opportunity to get rid of it in the Sydney and Melbourne markets, where it's being beaten by Channel 9. It wins in other markets around the country.
And given that, Ange, did she jump or was she pushed? Because, you know, in television, in the media industry, everyone quits.
No one really quits. Take it from me, you're pushed.
Who's the replacement? Who could it be? Because Nick Etchells,
is staying
mine, actually,
on. Yeah.
He's doing an incredible job. But, I mean, Mel Doyle was kind of shafted to Afternoon News and then a digital channel. Would she be someone who would step up?
She would be terrific, but that's if the show continues. This is the thing. Or if they, like Channel 9, decide to go quietly to an hour-long news. And, gosh, where did they get that idea? Chanel number 10, been doing it
first
for years.
First at five.
Yeah. So there's some speculation that they might do that.
What about Darren Hinch? Because I reckon when he gets out of jail.
Yeah, I was just going to say, did they not notice in the speculation yesterday they were saying Darren Hinch might take over as host? And I said, I'm pretty sure he's got 48 days of incarceration before that can happen.
He could go live cross from Pentridge.
He could.
He could maximum that security. He's going to jail.
I know.
I'm fun that's so ordinary.
Yeah.
The things you can do in this hellhole and not go to jail.
Yeah.
Well, and then
you can actually kill people.
people. Pay $100,000 fine, right. Wasn't it? It's a lot of bread.
It is.
He said he could pay it, though. He said he's doing this to make a stand.
I've totally got the money. I just choose to go to jail.
He's taking a stand.
Well, he's done things for a stand before. Yeah.
Well, that's true. That's true. Sometimes when you absent yourself, people are happy to see you on the other side.
But the thing with him, like, Hinch's entire career is reliant upon him going to jail.
And that is a unique way of doing things. He has he has blazed a trail.
Right. His greatest fear would be that they gave him a suspended sentence.
Now, let's head over to Hollywood. Producer Harvey Weinstein, he has surprised a few people with a very bold promise.
This is absolutely fascinating. Harvey Weinstein, the producer of movies like Pulp Fiction, Reservoir Dogs, Django Unchained, which you may have noticed had a bullet shot or two in them, has decided to make his next film with Meryl Streep as going to be an anti-NRA film, so National Rifle Association in the United States, called The Senator's Wife. And it's going to hedge upon how the legislation to curb gun ownership failed in the wake of the Sandy Hook massacre, the one where all the little children were shot in Newtown.
That's interesting because of Sean Penn coming out and saying he's gotten rid of his guns, and he's always been a big gunny guy because of going out with Charlize Theron.
Wow. Well, we love Charlize, the power of Charlize. The thing about Harvey, when he announced he was going to do this, the journalist rightly said, well, hang on. You know, you built your company on Pulp Fiction and these. Are you going to change the movies you make? And he has said yes. Movies with gratuitous violence will no longer be made by the Weinstein Company. No, about time. But they make money, Ida. They are successful at the box office. That is a very big call to make.
I mean, we
would love it if they didn't, but the fact is they do.
Oh, yes, Angela. Everything's fine if you make a buck.
Well, I'm not saying it's fine. I'm just saying that's reality.
We should just get a government propaganda unit and they can make all the movies. Oh, sorry, that already happened. It's called Sweden.
We should just ban every movie.
What are you going to do?
Ban
the movies. To make the movies, Joe. And to make the movies.
Imagine how lovely that would be.
The country. It's nice to be back.
Brought a bit of glitter back down.
Good job over there,
thank you very much.
Thanks.
Absolutely killed it. There is a lot more of Studio 10 right after this. Very short break. Stay right where you are. We'll be right back.